As you said, if a man has like 10 girlfriends,
mm-hmm.
he slept with 10 different women, and a woman slept with 10 different men, and they would have to come together.
But in history, women were always seen as the lesser of the two sexes. It's like what the man wants, that's it. What the woman, well, not even what the woman wants, because
they have to please.
She didn't
the
even
man.
Matter.
No, the
she
woman
was property.
Has to please.
The woman was property.
She was.
Hey, what up guys, and welcome back to the channel. So today we want to discuss the issue of this whole thing, the whole, what's the word? I'm looking for the word. It's at the tip of my tongue.
Sexism?
No, another word. Oh, the double standard when it comes to male and female, like, sexuality. Like, why is it with guys, if you've, like, the more women you've been with, the more vocal you are about your sexuality. Oh yeah, he's a man, he's macho, he's a man.
You get
but
popular foods.
Yeah, exactly. And with a woman, you better keep that body count low. If a man asks you and your number of people is too high, or if you're too vocal about what you want sexually, you're seen like a whore or like a loose person.
But I think this thing came from, I am thinking, because that's the only rationale I have, is that it came from the history of society being a man's society.
Yeah.
So a lot of things were acceptable for men. Men were allowed to do certain things and female were not. And then if female were
do stuff
certain things that were the same thing that men would do, it would look like they are like whores and what else?
Like they're low. You know, that brings me to another idea, because if we look back in history, before somebody got married, like especially in more cultured places, like the men had to like give a gift to her family. Basically like he was buying her like a bride price. And if she was a virgin,
the price was higher. Yeah.
So there was more value on women that were virgins and women who were chaste and whatever.
But and then if you look at it now, talking about it, it had nothing to do with the woman's value.
Exactly.
It had to do with the admirers, the way he felt and the way his expectation and what he wanted,
mm-hmm.
and how he was going to be pleased. Because if, for example, it's a virgin, that's why the price is higher. He knows a certain he will get a certain pleasure
like
with this.
No one else has ever been there, so.
Yeah, so things like that. So yeah, it was never about
the
woman.
It was never
woman.
About the women. Because if you look, in history, women were always seen as the lesser of the two sexes.
Yeah.
It's like what the man wants, that's it. What the woman, well, not even what the woman wants.
And they had to please the
man. She didn't even matter.
No,
she
woman
was
has
property.
To please.
The woman was property.
She was, it was believed, maybe still believed, that women were created to satisfy.
Yeah, that is still believed in a lot of cultures.
And the thing is, what we see too is that, as you said, if a man has like 10 girlfriends,
mm-hmm.
he slept with 10 different women, and a woman slept with 10 different men, and they would have to come together to talk about
She's gonna stay in her father's house, never getting married.
The man would be praised and would say, whoa, wow, he's, you know, he has the look, he
mm-hmm.
must have had something, and oh yeah, that he had all these girls
and
these women.
But then the woman
would say like,
like she's worthless at this point.
Yeah.
But that's the other thing, like if you flip it around now, right? If a man was a virgin and he was to get married, in certain situations, even the woman would have been like, why did nobody else want you? Like,
yeah,
why are
yeah,
you, why?
That's true.
You know? So the whole stereotypes, everything, it kind of feeds off of each other.
It does.
And it does come from a long history of the type of mentality where men are in charge and women are basically like, you know, just stay home, barefoot, pregnant, cook something, you know, that type of lifestyle.
Yeah. If a man like isn't sexually pleased or satisfied with his partner, he would feel just free and open to just talk about it.
Mm-hmm.
Look, you know, he would say, I want. But if a woman now
is not
satisfied or just wants certain things to happen, and she would just openly try to talk to her partner, depending, because not every partner is like that.
Like that, yeah.
She might possibly be seen as
Like, oh, how do you know about that? Somebody else been giving you that? Yeah. Oh, you this.
Or you're wild, or you're
promiscuous. Oh, I thought I married a good girl.
Yeah, things like that, yeah.
And so, that's the thing, too. The other thing, too, when it comes to the whole issue, it's like, with men and women, like, whatever the man does, it's supposed to please the woman right away. He can do no wrong. As long as he's put that thing there, it's supposed to be perfect. So if a woman comes now to tell her partner that, listen, I'm not really satisfied, like, that could really, like, break his ego, because in the way society was built up,
he's not doing something good,
because it's always like, oh, what? As long as you're getting that thing, it's supposed to be good, you know? Mm. Whereas with women, there's more pressure on, you have to please him, do stuff to please him.
But I think it's with the fact that the female body is more complex when it comes to the sexual feelings than a man. Like a man, once in the moment and the mood, it's just go. But a woman, she needs to be brought to the place. Like, it takes a while to heat that engine and it can easily cool down in the process. So, yeah, I think that's why you have, I think, a lot of female with sexual issues towards
their partner. A lot of women living and not ever having experienced, like, an orgasm or anything, because there's this whole hush-hush. You feel embarrassed to even tell your partner that, listen, I'm not satisfied and all that, because you don't want to be looked at in a negative light.
Because, yes, you do have men that want it in a, like, in an extreme way, mm-hmm. like, you know, with extreme stuff and all kinds of, and, you know, but I think the in general, for the male, once he is there, like, once he is heated, like, once mm-hmm. his hormonal charge and everything is up there, for the man, it's just go and deposit. That's it. That's why you see most of the time, soon as a man got climax,
for at least a period,
there is no interest. And also, biologically, the body
needs to.
So somehow the body, like, for a few minutes at least, they can't just jump back into it. And there, again, we can talk about the influence of media.
Yeah, because
where she's like, people just keep going and keep going. That's not
going
true.
It six cannot. Times.
Unless you're on drugs or whatever, some high, whatever.
Viagra?
Yeah, but other than that, no.
Yeah.
I personally don't believe that.
Yeah, that's real unfortunate, because, like, people can live in silence just because of, like, stereotypes that society has built around us. And even in 2020, like, no matter how progressive the world might seem, and women are out there, oh, I'm living my sexual freedom and all of that, like, you can say that as much as you want, but there is still this stigma and closed-mindedness when it comes to actually verbalizing what you really want.
And this is
a
huge issue between couples. It doesn't matter if they're married or not, but when one or both are not able to really express themselves or say what they really want, what they really like, and then because that lacks, it causes issues and problems. So, and then it can lead to divorce.
Yeah, because to me, I find that most things around sex is aimed towards satisfying the men. Like, the whole issue of sex is geared towards men. Like, I mean, not saying we do that, but look at, like, pornography and stuff. It's mostly geared towards men. When you go into stores and stuff with lingerie and all of that, like, who is that for? Who is that?
Because I even saw, like, yesterday on Facebook, somebody posted that they went to a store, I'm not saying the name, but it's like a regular, like a supermarket, and they went to buy vitamins, and right on the shelf, right next to the vitamin, they had vibrators for women, and so they were, and the discussion was, how can you have that right there in a normal supermarket where a family goes shopping with their kids to buy vitamins to give to their kids against cold, and then they see that thing right there.
But then that's a double standard.
So I think, so as you were saying, I don't think nowadays it's just geared to men only, because females have their stuff too.
Yeah, they do, right, but now, like, if you look at it, like, the percentage, like, the balance of it, it is a predominantly, like, women are in it a lot, but it's geared towards men. You know, so, and to me, that in itself can be a little bit difficult to maneuver
your likes and dislikes when it comes to sexual relations.
And let us know if you agree with us when we say that it seems to be a kind of double standard between men and women when it comes to vocalizing what you actually want in your bedroom life. So don't forget to hit the subscribe button, guys, and of course hit that notification bell so you'll never miss one of our uploads.
Also give us a like
and give us thumbs. A big fat thumbs up. Hit that thumbs up button, please, and thank you. So saying all that, I want you guys to always remember,
he who is without sin cast the first stone.
Yeah, guys, this is a judgment-free zone. So we hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day. So until next time. Bye.